Hello everyone, I'm Chad Dolbier with Stokes Volkswagen TV. Today's video is talking about how to get top dollar for your trade. So if you're selling your personal vehicle or trading it in at a car dealership, I want to give you some tips on how to get the most money for your car. So stay tuned with us for the next few minutes, and hopefully this video will help you come to an understanding on how to get the top dollar from your trade at a car dealership. So here we go. So you want to get top dollar for your trade. Well, how can you do it? Well, first of all, I'm going to go over a few things today to teach you how to do that. In the car world, you definitely want to do these things to get top dollar for your trade. So just stay with us here for a second, because I'm going to tell you some really pertinent information on getting the money you want for your car. Now think for a moment. You're online, you want to see how much is your car worth, because you're just tired of driving it and you want to get a new vehicle because you got car fever maybe, right? Well, maybe you go to KellyBlueBook.com or NADA and you look up trade-in value, you look up private party, you look up retail value on your car, and you see, okay, these are the values on my vehicle and maybe I can get that for it. Well, let's slow down for just a moment. People come in on a day-to-day basis to sell their vehicles to us, and sometimes vehicles come into the dealership that are dirty, they're rough, they're below average. And then some customers bring their cars in tip-top shape, nice and clean. They have all their service records and things like that. Now just think for a moment. If you are out trying to sell your vehicle on Craigslist or Auto Trader yourself, and someone's set up an appointment with you and they're gonna come and meet you at the Walmart parking lot and take a look at your car and then go for a test drive, would you not make sure your car is clean? Would you not make sure you have the service records and things like that on your vehicle? Sure you would. Again, you're trying to sell it yourself. You wanna get top dollar for your vehicle. So you can take that money, pay off a loan, or possibly put some money down on a new vehicle, right? So there you go. Now let's take a look here for just a moment. We have a little list here. I want to go ahead and first of all tell you some of the questions that a car dealership will ask you when you're trading or selling your vehicle to a dealership. These are great questions. Make sure you answer them properly and truthfully so we can come up with a good conclusion to be able to give you the best amount of money for your car. So let's go ahead and run through these questions kind of quickly here and let you see what they are. Now at the top of the list here, it's going to have basic information like customer name, date, address, all that stuff. What brought you to the dealership today? That's a great question. Did you see us on TV? Did you hear us on the radio? Did you find us on the web, Facebook, YouTube, whatever? Let us know. It's really important because we're trying to do our marketing and things like that. It's a great question. But anyways, let's don't get off track here. We're trying to figure out how to get the top dollar for your trade. First question, how many miles are on your car? Just answer it. If you don't know exactly how many miles on it, if you didn't jot them down before you walked in the store, just say, the car's got 94,000 miles roughly right around there. Somebody will go outside, the appraiser or the car salesman, and they'll take a look at the odometer and see what the mileage is. Question number two, has your car ever had paint work? Answer that one honestly. If you haven't had any paint work done on the vehicle since you've owned it, great. If you have, just say, yeah, the car went to the shop at some point and it had some paint done on it. Because that's going to follow up to question three, has your car ever suffered body or frame damage? If you've been in a major car accident, your car could have had frame damage or body damage, and then that would have accrued into having paint work done on your vehicle. Number four, has your car ever had flood damage? Here in South Carolina in 2015, we'd had a terrible flood and rainstorm. So a lot of vehicles have been saturated on the roads in Charleston, South Carolina and South Carolina that have been in flood and may have water damage. That's a question that needs to be answered, folks, because we all need to know. You want to be able to pass on the information to the next person buying the vehicle. Number five, did you buy your vehicle new? That's basically letting us know if it's a one-owner vehicle or not. We will pull Carfax report on your vehicle and learn the history of it and things like that. But hey, it's a great question. Number six, does your vehicle have any transmission problems? If you're not an expert on transmissions, just say, well, I don't know if it has any transmission problems, but it does jerk a little bit in gear, things like that. Hey, you never know. People do try to trade in cars at some point that have transmission problems and don't tell anybody. And the next thing you know, the dealership's calling you back saying, hey, we got to rewind this deal, blah, 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 blah. It's not fun. We don't need to go that direction, folks. So try to be honest on these questions. Number seven, is there a spare tire and jack in the vehicle? Safety definitely first. If there's not a spare tire on the vehicle, if there's not a spare tire in the vehicle or a jack, you can only assume that the car dealership will have to buy one of those and put it in the vehicle so the next owner can have these safety features on their vehicle. With that being said, again, that goes into getting the most money for your trade. Please make sure that all the things that you have that came with the vehicle when you bought it are still there. Question number 8, may a prospective buyer contact you? If you don't want it, anyone calling you for privacy reasons, no problem. But if you do, no big deal. It's just trying to let the next customer know a little bit of the history of the vehicle, things like that. Especially if you had some kind of super exotic car or something that's been altered or, you know, hooked up, a tuner vehicle, something like that. They may want to talk to the previous person. But if you give us all your service records and things like that, we may not need to call you. Also, I wanted to bring up, since we just mentioned service records, make sure you take a Sharpie marker and black out your name and address and all those privacy things if you do give the service records to the dealership. It's a good thing. You don't need people calling or coming to your house and things like that. Privacy, definitely everybody wants it. Number 9, does your car have any paint, sealant, or rust proofing applied? Just answer it as honest as you can. You may not know the answer to that question. Number 10, does your vehicle have a balance or a service contract? Think about it for just a minute. A service contract, that may be some additional warranty, gap insurance, things like that in finance that you bought when you bought the vehicle, when you financed it originally. A balance on the car, a payoff, okay? It is very important to know the 10-day payoff on your vehicle, so while trading it in, we'll know that we can either pay the vehicle off and things like that. So definitely, before you come into the dealership, make sure you go online with your financial company and figure out what the 10-day payoff and per diem and all that stuff is on your vehicle. Service contract. Did you know that if you did buy a warranty on your vehicle, that you can actually get a refund on that warranty if you didn't use it to the full extent? Okay, so let's say 2 years ago you bought a warranty on your car. Let's say the warranty was $1,500. Now today we're trying to trade our car in. The warranty's still there. You used half of it, let's say. Well, guess what? The finance company will go through and figure out that, hey, we need to cut this guy a refund back because he doesn't own the car and we don't need to charge him for something that's actually been, hasn't been used fully. So there's a little extra money there for you can get cut back to the finance company. Pretty nice, isn't it? To get a little extra money in your pocket. Number 11, what equipment will be removed from your vehicle? So here's a great, that's a great lead into what I'm about to tell you. Customer comes in, they got 22-inch chrome wheels on their car. They sit down with us, they say, I want to trade it in on this beautiful Volkswagen Touareg, okay? We go through the deal, we work the deal, all that good stuff. We give you a number on your car. Let's just throw a number out there and say we're going to give you $22,000 for your Chevrolet Tahoe with 22-inch rims. Then at the end of the deal, you say, hey, oh, hold on a minute, can y'all take the rims off, put the factory ones back on? Well, let me tell you, folks, at that point, the trade-in value changes. It changes. There's no going back, okay? The trade-in value changes because they put a number on your car with those beautiful alloy wheels. So please let us know if there's any aftermarket features or anything like that on your car that you may want to take off before we put a number on your vehicle. So right there. And then the used car manager will go through and check off if it's an above average, average, or below average vehicle. So again, all these questions, being upfront and honest while answering them, is definitely a great thing to do so you can get top dollar for your trade. Okay, everybody, so you've seen the list of things that an actual manager or salesperson will ask you about your trade-in. Pretty self-explanatory questions, just answer them the best of your knowledge. But here is the real way to actually get the most money for your trade. First impression. Now just think for a moment. If you're online and you're trying to sell your vehicle private party, you got it on Craigslist, you got it on Auto Trader, you've spent $20, $30 on some of these websites to push it out there. Maybe you posted your car on Facebook for sale. Now, if someone calls you or emails you and says, hey, Mr. Smith, I'd like to meet with you and buy your vehicle, or I'd like to meet with you and take a look at your vehicle, and you say, yeah, let's do it. Let's go meet at Walmart, and you'll meet at the parking lot, let them look at your car, all that, and let them take a test drive. Now, would you not clean your vehicle before you take it to the dealership or take it to that place to let them look at it? Sure you would. Again, you want to get top dollar for your trade. So that's kind of what I'm getting ready to talk about over the next minute or so, is cleanliness and maintenance and things like that. Because again, first impressions are everything. So when you come to the dealership and that manager comes out and he wants to actually go look at your vehicle to put a number on it and see what number will be comfortable for you to get for your vehicle, whether you need to get payoff for it, or whatever that is. they're going to have to look at that car and they're going to have to take that vehicle out on the road and take it for a test drive. I mean, it's just that simple. So here's a few tips that you can do to be able to ensure getting top dollar for your trade. First, bring service records with you to the dealership. Service records are important. If you've been servicing your vehicle at a car dealership or at Jiffy Lube or any of those places, bring some of those records with you so you can say, hey, I have the last 2 years of service records, or the last year, the last 6 months of service records on this car, showing that these are the maintenance things I've been doing on the vehicle and all that to take care of that car. Secondly, make sure you get a Sharpie marker and black out your name and address and all that kind of stuff for privacy reasons. So that's the first thing. Bring service records with you. Second, cleanliness. Wash your car. Right now on screen, right here, you're gonna see a black Honda Civic that was traded in at one of our dealerships. This vehicle's not been through the reconditioning department, hasn't been through the shop or anything like that. It was literally just traded in. There's also a silver Honda Accord sitting right next to it that I've pulled up, so you can take a look at that. Now, the difference in the silver Honda Accord and the black Honda Civic is the silver Honda is clean, and it's very nice. The black Honda is extremely dirty, the interior is dirty, and the car is just not in the best shape. Still, they're cool looking cars and all, the Honda Civic, but having a clean vehicle and being well maintained is the true way to get top dollar for your trade when selling it to a car dealership. So make sure before you come to the store, go by the car wash, Cactus Car Wash, let them wash your vehicle, clean the interior out. The Honda Civic, as you can see right now on video, is extremely dirty. It's got scratches. It wasn't washed. The rims are dirty. The tires are bald. The interior is filthy. The Honda Civic, obviously the owner had an animal or a dog, so you can see hair all over the back seats, things like that. If you or me wanted to walk out to that car and take it out for a test drive with it being dirty and dust everywhere and things like that, would you want to sit in there with your nice suit on or white shirt and go drive that car? No, you wouldn't. And you got to understand, people in the car business are usually dressed a little bit nicer. So cleanliness is definitely a must on your trade-in. I'm not saying it has to be in perfect condition, but at least clean the car out so it's not filled with dirt and muck and dog hair and things like that. Again, that's going to make the trade-in value go down instead of go up. And today, we're trying to get our trade-in value to go up because you want the most money for it, right? That's right, you want to be able to put that money down on the next car or have your car paid off and you're not upside down. There you go. So cleanliness, service records, tires. I'm not saying you got to put brand new tires on your vehicle, but bringing in a car with bald tires is probably not the way to go. You may say, well, I just don't want to dump another $500 into the car. Well, that's fine, but do expect that when you sell your vehicle to the dealership, that they are going to have to put tires on the car. They're going to have to change the oil. They're going to have to clean it, recondition it, and all that. And a vehicle like that black Honda Civic that is that nasty, it's not just getting a regular wash and back in the detail shop back here. It's got to get a full detail on that car, and that costs time and money. So when you look at all those factors there, time and money on getting that car back up to pristine shape so it can sit out here on a beautiful dealership lot to be for sale, to sell to somebody else, they got to put money into it. So that right there can make your trade-in value go down because they got to put money into the car and have to buy it at a good price to still be able to sell it and make some kind of profit here at the dealership. So those are just some of the key things to do on your car. Cleanliness, service records, be honest with the car dealership, and just make sure your car is not like that Honda Civic and that rough, okay? It's just that simple. Thank you for watching the video today at Stokes Volkswagen. I'm Chad Dolbiere. Hopefully some of these tips will help you to get more money for your trade-in value. We'll see you soon. Have a great day, and thanks for watching.